Hi, welcome to SVR Sports Fix. My name is Peter Loschak. Today is Wednesday, November 14th, and this is our weekly call with Steve from collegefootballwinning.com, where we go over one game from the upcoming college football slate in depth, and we're going to cover an interesting one right now. Michigan State as a small road favorite coming off the loss to Ohio State at Nebraska. Steve from collegefootballwinning.com, thanks for being back with us. How are things going at your website this year?
Things are going well, Peter. Thank you for asking. This year, we are 71-49-2, which is 59.17% against the spread. Lifetime, you know, coming into the season, we're 60.66% against the spread. So we're right now this week just shy of our sort of historical standard.
All right, Steve, nice job. The game we're going to cover this week, Michigan State against Nebraska. Again, a very interesting game. Michigan State, an elite defense, obviously, but problems offensively and coming off of the big loss to Ohio State. How deflating will that loss be? And they're going on the road against Nebraska, which is also an interesting version of Nebraska that we're seeing this year. Their defense hasn't quite been stout, but they've been getting turnovers recently. Their offense, of course, has been very productive, leading to high scores and leading to wins and covers for them recently. And the question now is just how much will Michigan State's defense be able to hold down Nebraska's explosive offense? How much will Michigan State's problems offensively matter against a defense that isn't likely to pressure them as much as other of the better defenses in the Big Ten would? And how much of a psychological factor is the coming off of the loss to Ohio State for Michigan State here? Michigan State's a 2 or 2.5 point road favorite. What do you think, Steve?
Well, you said it, Peter. To put some numbers to your analysis of offenses and defenses here, Nebraska's offense ranks 14th in the country in yards per play versus the FBS. But they're facing, like you said, Michigan State's defense ranking 16th in yards per play allowed versus the FBS. Now, on the flip side of that, Michigan State's offense ranks 117th in yards per play versus the FBS, but they get to face Nebraska's defense that ranks 98th in yards per play allowed versus the FBS. So just as you set it up, we have a great defense versus a great offense. So who wins this? Well, even though Michigan State's head coach Mark D'Antonio does not like to give out injury information, there's no way we could talk about this matchup without talking about injuries. They play such a huge role in this matchup here, in my opinion. For Michigan State, they've been having offensive linemen coming in and out. They are now officially without running back L.J. Scott. They're going to redshirt him this year. Who's L.J. Scott for someone who has not watched Michigan State the last four seasons? Michigan State's leading rusher for the past three seasons. Consequently, without him, their running game is left to underclassmen, which has led to Michigan State's worst rushing production in Mark D'Antonio's 12 seasons as head coach at Michigan State. They are without now, and they've been without for the last few games, wide receiver Felton Davis III. He's the leading receiver this year, still is, even though he's missed the last few games. And last year, they're consequently, without Davis, their passing yards per attempt fell from 7.62 yards per attempt with Davis in to 5.07 yards per attempt with Davis out. That is obviously quite significant. But another big part of that poor passing production is because Michigan State's starting quarterback, Brian Lewerke, has been hurt since the Penn State game. Lewerke has been the starter this season and last season, so this is their starting quarterback. Here is where Mark D'Antonio's, his loyalty to his players, I think he can be loyal to a fault. In this case, he appears to want to stay with Lewerke, but Lewerke himself has admitted to not being able to make all the throws because of his injury. So no doubt, just like last game, we're going to be seeing the freshman quarterback, Rocky Lombardi. This is a guy who has completed just 48.6% of his passes. I'm not necessarily picking on him, per se. This is in part, at least in part, because he's not gotten a lot of meaningful game reps, even when Michigan State had the opportunity to do this earlier in the season. So, and that, again, is in part because of D'Antonio's loyalty to his starter, Lewerke. So, despite Michigan State's awesome defense, this game could very well become Michigan State trying to keep pace with one of the nation's best total offenses, led by Nebraska quarterback freshman Adrian Martinez, who averages 317.6 yards per game of offensive production versus FBS competition. That's 12th in the nation for this dual-threat quarterback. Martinez is obviously an extremely talented freshman quarterback, and he's on the trajectory, Peter, that we would expect talented quarterbacks who are young to be on as the season matures. So you could see this quantitatively in his first five games. He was responsible for 9 touchdowns, that's rushing and passing, and 5 interceptions. His last 4 games, his most recent 4 games, 13 touchdowns and just 2 interceptions. So tremendous improvement there. Michigan State has only faced one quarterback ranked higher in offensive production than Martinez, and that's Dwayne Haskins last week from Ohio State. Michigan State lost that game 26-6, but they did do a good job of limiting Haskins' production. The trouble for Michigan State is Haskins is not the running threat that Martinez is. The next closest quarterback Michigan State has faced this year to Martinez, this dual threat that Martinez is, I think was Arizona State's Manny Wilkins, who's ranked currently 30th in yards per game total offensive production. And Wilkins, against Michigan State, against this great defense from Michigan State, was responsible for 405 yards versus Michigan State. Now, he averages 282 yards per game, so his production went up playing this great defense. And Michigan State, as you might remember, lost that game on the road 16-13. Now, despite Nebraska losing 7 of its 10 games straight up this season, they have outgained 6 of their 10 opponents this year, so their straight-up record is a little deceiving. And speaking of Nebraska improving as the season matures, just like Adrian Martinez has their fresh quarterback, the proof is in their margin of victory against the spread, Peter. The first 6 games, their average per game margin of victory against the spread, -10.7 per game. Their last 4 games, their average margin of victory against the spread is +6 per game. So you see that tremendous shift. Now, even though Scott Frost is in his first year as a head coach at Nebraska, Michigan State's head coach, Mark D'Antonio, has been the head coach at Michigan State for the past 12 seasons, as I said. And this will be his 6th time facing Nebraska. Now, he's covered the spread, as Michigan State teams have covered the spread just once against Nebraska. You know, Peter, I like to make quantitative arguments for why I like certain sides. But for this game, there is a qualitative note here that I want to add. And that's the mood surrounding each of these teams. It's very different. So Nebraska started off horribly, surprisingly bad. Even for the young team, it's still Nebraska. But Nebraska, now that they have progressed and we've seen the improvement, the mood surrounding Nebraska is hopeful, it's enthusiastic, it's encouraging. Everyone, fans included, can see the improvement in this team as the season has progressed. And they know that Scott Frost can do, at the very least, an incredible job with the offense. He's already done with this young team. Michigan State, on the other hand, very different. Really upset with quarterback decisions. There have been so many injury issues that led to a lot of trainer speculations, training, practicing speculation. And they have an offense. It has gotten progressively worse the past 4 seasons. So fans are calling for the offensive coordinator's head. Offensively, it's a tire fire out there. So for Nebraska, they know and they have accepted that this team cannot go to a bowl game this year. This game that they're about to play, Peter, is their final game in Memorial Stadium. So it's their final home game. This game is senior day. They're honoring 19 seniors, 9 of whom are starters. So last time for those 19 guys, the 9 starters, seniors, playing at Memorial Stadium. And, you know, Memorial Stadium is arguably the most special home field experience in all of football. They have an NCAA record 368 consecutive sold-out games. And it's incredible. It dates back to 1962. So, obviously, it means a ton for these guys to be playing their final game here at this stadium. My conclusion, as you can tell, Peter, I like the Nebraska side. As this is being recorded, You can find Nebraska at +2.5 offshore at plenty of places like Pinnacle, Bovada, Five Dimes, BetDSI, Heritage, the Creek, other places. And here in Las Vegas at the Superbook at the Westgate and Treasure Island, name a couple. But we recommend buying off of that 2.5. So find your 2.5, buy off of it to get the line to +3, even if you have to pay as much as -127, so -127, to get that half point.
All right, sounds good. And Steve from collegefootballwinning.com making a very compelling argument for a Nebraska as a home dog against Michigan State. Tell us what you do at your website, collegefootballwinning.com, Steve.
Thank you, Peter. At collegefootballwinning.com, all the company does is make college football betting recommendations. So no other sports and no other leagues within the sport. So not the NFL, only college football. We're a company founded on making betting recommendations using sets of algorithms. And we call those algorithmic betting recommendations our formula. The lifetime coming into the season for the formula was 60.66% against the spread. This season, for all of our betting recommendations, not just the formula,
I just let him go.
We're 59.17% against the spread. Very hopeful for the last few weeks of the season that that's going to go even higher. That's all good. The bad news is we are currently closed to new clients, but you can still come to collegefootballwinning.com and you can get on our waiting list, and we hope that you do.
Thank you so much, Steve. Talk to you again next week.